Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are going to learn everything about when to use the passé composé. On the book it's page 115 to 119. So the passé composé is a tense, obviously, of the past. And it's all about a very specific time frame, without being very clear about the time frame. Not a tense that we use only to say blah 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 happened between 10 and 10:30. It's not how it works. We know that the action started and stopped in the past. So with the passé composé, it's fully done. The passé composé is never going to come into the present tense. So it's all about the action that started in the past and was done in the past. We are going to see a lot of situations here, a lot of examples. You will see it's not that hard. So today we are going to focus on frequently used words that indicate the passé composé. And also I'm going to give you a few verbs at the end that are conjugated with avoir and être. So we use the passé composé to talk about something that happened in the past, obviously, with a reference of time, such as hier, hier, yesterday, il y a deux jours, il y a deux jours, 2 days ago, l'été dernier, last summer, mercredi dernier, last Wednesday, or even ce matin, this morning. Of course, you have more examples in the book. Let's see. Il est arrivé ce matin. Il est arrivé ce matin. He arrived this morning. So this is the verb arriver conjugated with être. I'm always going to give you them just to review and because some of the ones that we are going to use in this lesson are irregular. Il a plu la semaine dernière. Il a plu la semaine dernière. It rained last week. So this is the verb pleuvoir conjugated with avoir. Don't forget that pleuvoir is an impersonal verb only conjugated with il only. Here you can do the exercise 2.10. We also use the passé composé to describe an event that usually only happens once. Usually. Let's see common verbs used with the passé composé. We have mourir, mourir, to die, only happens once. Naître, to be born, also once. Se marier, to get married, that can happen a few times. Then we have avorter, to abort, and avoir, to turn, years old. Il est mort l'année dernière. Il est mort l'année dernière. He died last year. So this is the verb mourir conjugated with être. J'ai récemment eu 30 ans. J'ai récemment eu 30 ans. I recently turned 30 years old. So this is avoir conjugated with avoir. When you're done with this one, you can do the exercise 2.11. The third way that we have to use the passé composé is to talk about something that happened repeatedly or at least a few times. If we see a sentence, j'ai visité le Canada deux fois. J'ai visité le Canada deux fois. I visited Canada twice. So this is the verb visiter with avoir. So here we are sure that it's something that happened a few times since we have deux fois. So we could have trois fois, quatre fois, cinq fois, etc. We will not say une fois, for example, that's not gonna happen. We will say I visited Canada in 2015, for example. But you know, I'm going to say I visited Canada once. It's not wrong, it just doesn't sound natural. When you understand that, you can do the exercise 2.12. We also use the passé composé to talk about something that happened suddenly. And we also have a list of verbs that indicate the passé composé as well. We have, well, soudainement, suddenly, tout à coup, all of a sudden, tout de suite, right away, juste quand, just when. La police est arrivée tout de suite. La police est arrivée tout de suite. The police arrived right away. So here this is the verb arriver conjugated with être. Le magicien a disparu tout à coup. Le magicien a disparu tout à coup. Magician disappeared all of a sudden. So this is the verb. Disparaître, conjugate with avoir. So you see, all those actions are done and we know exactly when it happened. The police arrived. That's it. They were there. The magician disappeared. That's it. He was gone. Okay? When you're good, you can do the exercise 2.13. We also use the passé composé to talk about a series of actions that happened successively. And in the sentences, we're going to have words such as d'abord, first, enfin, finally, ensuite, then, puis, then as well. So let's see a little sentence that I wrote like I was looking for someone. D'abord, j'ai essayé de l'appeler au bureau. Puis, j'ai appelé son téléphone portable. Enfin, j'ai appelé sa secrétaire. So first, I tried to call him at work. Then I called his cell phone. Finally, I called his secretary. So let's look at each action here. J'ai essayé de l'appeler au bureau. Done. Puis, j'ai appelé son téléphone portable. Done. And finally, j'ai téléphoné à sa secrétaire. Done. Okay? All the actions are over. Okay? Over in the past, passé composé. When you're good, you can do the exercise 2.14. Now, let's see a few verbs that we can conjugate with être and avoir. So we just saw all the verbs conjugated with avoir, we saw all the verbs conjugated with être. But the thing is, a few of them can be conjugated with both. And the meaning change quite a bit. They are very easy to understand, you will see. Let's look at descendre, to go down. So if you look at it with être, we have je suis descendu. Je suis descendu. I went downstairs. But if you look at it with avoir, we can say j'ai descendu la poubelle. J'ai descendu la poubelle. I took the garbage downstairs. So here, the main difference is that with avoir, we can have a direct object. We can't have a direct object with être. That's the main difference. J'ai descendu quoi? La poubelle. Okay? Same thing with monter, to go up. Il est monté. Il est monté. He went upstairs. But, il a monté la valise au grenier. Il a monté la valise au grenier. He took the luggage to the attic. Il a monté quoi? La valise. So the first one does not allow a COD, complément d'objet direct, direct object. But the second one does. Let's see, rentrer as to go home. Elle est rentrée à la maison. Elle est rentrée à la maison. She went home. And then, elle a rentré la voiture. Elle a rentré la voiture. She took the car in. So, elle a rentré quoi? La voiture. Does not happen with être. Only with avoir. The last one we are going to see is sortir. Sortir, to go out, to leave, to exit. We're going to see to go out. Vous êtes sorti dehors. Vous êtes sorti dehors. You went outside. Or, vous avez sorti le chien. Vous avez sorti le chien. You took the dog outside. Vous avez sorti qui? Le chien. COD. Direct object. That's it. That's all about that. So I always say that you can either remember it like that with the direct object, or you can also remember it as the subject. So if we take vous êtes sorti dehors, this is all about the subject. This is all about vous. But if we look at the dog, this is all about the dog. So this is the main difference. So you can remember it this way, either with the subject or either with the direct object. Whatever works best for you. When you understand that, you can do the exercise 2.15. Tomorrow we are going to learn everything about the passé composé of reflexive verbs. So I will see you tomorrow. À demain.